بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أصحاب الفخامة والسمو والسعادة، الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أود في بداية هذه الكلمة أن أعرب عن خالص تقديري وامتناني للرئيس أدما بارو ولحكومة وشعب جمهورية غامبيا على كرم الضيافة وحسن الاستقبال في استضافة الدورة 15 لمؤتمر قمة منظمة التعاون الإسلامي، وهي القمة التي تلعب دوراً بارزاً في تعزيز الوحدة والتضامن من خلال الحوار لتحقيق التنمية المستدامة. ومن هذا المقام لا بد من توجيه الشكر الجزيل للرئاسة السابقة ممثلة في المملكة العربية السعودية التي أدارت دفة المنظمة بكل حكمة واقتدار، مما أسهم في تعزيز مسيرة التعاون الإسلامي في مختلف المجالات. أصحاب الفخامة والسمو والسعادة، نجتمع اليوم والعالم يمر بتحديات جمة ومتصاعدة، وفي ظل هذه التطورات الخطيرة يبرز دور مجلس التعاون ومنظمة التعاون الإسلامي بوصفهما قوتين فاعلتين لمواجهة الأزمات المتعددة التي تشهدها منطقتنا والعالم أجمع. فإن التحديات المشتركة التي نواجهها تستدعي منا جميعاً العمل المشترك والتعاضد في سبيل تعزيز قيم السلام والازدهار، خاصاً بالذكر ما تتعرض إليه فلسطين وقطاع غزة من هجوم
Coming on a difficult serious aggression, and also we welcome commend the extraordinary summit held by the Arab League in Riyadh last year, and from which stemmed a ministerial committee and that informed and exposed to the whole world the plight and suffering of the people in Gaza when it comes to the protection of civilians during this period. And we commend the effort of this committee in order to put an end to aggression in Gaza, and also in solidarity with Arab positions in the Gulf and everywhere. And today, we, after 211 days, after 12, during which the plight of the Palestinian people has increased, and under the occupation of Israeli forces, over 32,000 children and women have been suffering, and there are over 5,000 casualties. And this affects and threatens our stability in the light of all crises that take place in the Middle East. So this Israeli occupation and also aggression requires from us to be committed to collective action in support of the people of Palestine and their rights. So in this regard, we would like to confirm the important role that our organization is playing in the interest of peace and stability and the fight against terrorism that threatens international stability. So here we can indicate the relevance of the Security Council to host and organize international conference to ensure stability in the entire world. So because of all these difficulties at face, we have to promote the peace of we should ensure solidarity and stability among us. Your Excellencies and Highnesses, based on the theme of this summit, that is solidarity and peace, in order to ensure solidarity and dialogue, we have to shed light on the importance of sustainable development in the agenda of the Gulf Cooperation Council and the Organization of Islamic Conference, because this requires from all of us joint action in order to overcome the challenges, economic challenges that affect our countries and peoples. So in this regard, we should consolidate cooperation in science and technology in order to support sustainable development projects. And since the youth are the backbone of the Muslim Ummah, in this regard, we should provide all support to them through education and training, and provide employment opportunities for them, and boost their capacities. And through that, we can ensure strong societies that can participate effectively in the international arena. Your Excellencies, Your Highnesses, I would like to conclude my statement by drawing your kind attention to two important issues. First of all, the members of the Gulf Corporate Council are proud of their belonging to the Muslim world at all levels, and it will extend a hand of cooperation to all Muslim countries, because it believes in the importance of this generosity and this to strengthen these ties and relations based on our religion. And number two, I would like to commend the major efforts that are being made by the Republic of the Gambia, especially when it comes to hosting this summit that promotes the values of our organization. Let us all work for the unity of our Muslim Ummah, governed by the spirit of peace and stability. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Thank you for your kind attention.